Okay. Welcome. This is R. Premananda, Assistant Professor, Government Engineering College, Aveyri. Here now we are going to discuss the problem on the node voltage analysis. This is the circuit diagram which has been given. And the question is asked to find the current in each branch. Okay, branch, may recall this as we have to find the current IABC, comma, ICD, the another branch, comma, ICE, comma, IEF, comma, IEGH. Okay, these are the currents we are supposed to find. Okay, IEGH current we have to find. Okay, so that we know that in the previous while discussing the theory, we come across the formula for the node voltage analysis that G11, the sum of all conductance connected to the node 1 into V1, okay, node voltage 1 plus G12 V2 is equal to I1, where I1 is equal to E1 by R1. In this diagram, we may call this as R1, okay, or else. Okay, this was the equation number 1 which have been written in the previous discussion. And similarly, G21 V2 plus G22 V2 is equal to I2. What is I1 and I2? Sum of all the source currents connected to the node 1 and node 2 respectively. Okay, which is given by E2 by R1. See, for simple node voltage analysis, we need not worry about the direction of the current. See, it has been given the formula by the node voltage concept. G11 means the sum of the all the conductance connected to the node voltage 1. Okay, see, for node voltage 1, we have taken V1 and V2 as node voltages. And this is the reference node. Okay, that this is the reference node which is connected to the zero potential. Or recall it as the earth. See, what are the resistance connected? 1, 2 ohm is connected, 4 ohm is connected, and 5 ohm is connected. So, according to that, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5 into V1. Okay. Sum of all the conductance connected to the node 1. That is called G11. And this 5 ohm is connected between V1 and node 1 and node 2. Because of that, minus 1 by 5 V2 is equal to the voltage source. There is no current source. Instead, we have got voltage source. So, voltage source can be converted to current source by the formula V divided by the resistance. Okay, this is, okay. We'll simplify and later. So, the solving all this, we get 0.9 V1. Minus 0.2 V2 is equal to 5. Call this is the equation 1. Call this is the equation 1. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 5. Okay, solving that we get. Okay, I'll build the calc. Okay, in this calc, use this bracket. See, 1 by 2. 1 is the angle symbol is there, divided by 2. This is 1 by 2. Plus 1 by 5, 1 angle symbol 5, plus 1 by 4, okay, press, you will get 19 by 20, see here, 19 by 20, press the same thing, it will show in the decimal value, that is 0.95, okay. Similarly, 1 divided by 5, so it will show in 1 by 5, press the same that will show in the decimal, 0.2, okay? Okay. Okay, this is the equation 1. Okay, next equation, G21, means you may write this as for node 1. Now, you may write here it as for node 2, means you have to write equation for node 2. See, for node 2, we have got 5 ohm, 8 ohm, 10 ohm resistances. whereas 5 ohm resistances is shared between node 1 and node 2, because of that minus 1 by 5 V1, minus 1 by 5 V1, and plus, that is 1 by 5, 1 by 8, 1 by 10. So that 1 by 5 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 10 into V2 is equal to E2 by 10. Okay, E2 is 20 and divided by 10 is 10. Okay, E2 by resistance. E2 is equal to 20 volt is the source voltage and 10 ohm. Okay, with this, this becomes minus 0.2 V1 plus 0.425, as I showed just now, use that concept, 0.425 V2 is equal to 2. This is another equation, is equal to 2. Okay, and solving, okay, see this, from equation 1 to equation 2, you may write this as A1, B1, and this is C1, and this is A2, B2, and this is C2. Only two unknowns are there, so A1, B1 will get, okay. So use this calci. First write in the equation mode, it is equation 1 is there, mat 2 and vector 3, press equation 1 and two unknowns, press 2, okay. After that, the value of A1, it asks value of A1, that is 0.9, value of B1, that is minus 0.2, and the value of C1, that is 5, and value of A2, the value of it is, that is minus 0.2, value of B2, that is 0.425, and value of C2, that is 2. So answer is 7.37, answer is 7.37. See, that is 0.95, that is not 0.9, that is 0.95, okay. So substituting A1 is 0.95, B2 is minus 0.2, C1 is 5. Similarly, A2 is minus 0.2, B2 is 0.425, and C2 is 2. With this, X is nothing but the value of V1, we get V1. V1 is equal to 6.94 volt, and V2 is equal to, press another time X equal sign, you'll get Y means here V2, that is 7.97 volt. So we got V1 and V2 values. Okay. See, so from figure, you may write that, okay, E current IABC. IABC is nothing but the current through 2 ohm is nothing but E1 minus V1 divided by 2. E1 minus V1 divided by 2. What is E1? E1 is 10 minus 6.94 divided by 2 divided by 2. The answer here is 1.53. Answer is 1.53 ampere. Okay. And to find the current through ICD, that is this branch, that is nothing but V1 by 4. V1 is the voltage, and next another, it is 0, so it is V1 by 4. What is V1? We have found that one, 6.94 divided by 4, and the current is 0.735. Current is 1.735. 1.735 ampere. Okay, and then I have to find the current ICE. See, this is the current ICE. So that is, if I take ICE, first term is C, means I have to take V1 minus V2 divided by 5. V1 is 6.94 minus 7.97 divided by 5, and the answer is minus 0.206, minus 0.206 ampere. See, minus indicates I have assumed the current direction from C to E. This is wrong. The current direction should be E to C. Okay, the magnitude remains the same. Only the direction is going to be the change. Okay. After that, I want to find the current IEF. IEF current. That is nothing but the current in this arm. The current in this arm. That is nothing but IEF is equal to V2 by 8. What is V2? 7.97 we have obtained divided by 8. And the answer is 0.996. Answer is 0.9996 ampere. And next is current IEGH. See, I have started from the IE. Okay, so you will have that V2 first. I have started from the E, so V2 will first minus E2 divided by 10 ohm. E2 first minus E2 divided by 10 ohm. That is 7.97 minus 20 divided by 10. And the answer is minus 1.203. This means that this indicates that the current direction what I am assuming is wrong. We are supposed to get the another direction. Okay, opposite direction. That is, if you start from the edge, you will get the positive value. Okay, we will discuss some more problems in the next class.